Minnesota Fighting Vikings wide receiver Laquon Treadwell has been a little bit of a punchline. You know you made him since being the number 23 overall pick in the 2016 NFL draft before Michael Thomas. We didn't need Michael Thomas. But first-round pick Laquon Treadwell was a bust. But league minimum free agent signing Laquon Treadwell has been pretty eyed. So show some respect to successful Quan today. Also, show some respect to this channel. Subscribe, Daily Vikings Takes. Also, the drums now that like is already in. Helps new people find the show, helps the channel grow. We're almost over 20K. Who would have known? Also, give us a like and follow on Twitch as well as on the Facebook, baby. There you go. All right, so Laquon Treadwell. Picked in 2016 because Teddy needed a tall receiver, even though Treadwell is the same height as Thielen. But, you know. But at that point, Diggs wasn't Diggs yet. Thielen wasn't Thielen yet. So it's understandable why the Vikings were interested in a wide receiver in the first round. Didn't get Josh Doctson. And then we got Josh Doctson. And then we cut Josh Doctson. Whatever. Also didn't get Will Fuller. Missed out on Corey Coleman. Dodged that one. And also, you know, picked Treadwell over Michael Thomas. But other than that. Yeah, and we've discussed on this channel at length about the factors that went into why he didn't pan out. I think number one, I don't think he was fully healed from that horrific leg ankle injury he suffered in 2014. Yes, he did come back his junior year, put up 1,000 yards in the Big Bad SEC, but also I think coming in his rookie year still wasn't quite all the way back. Number two was ego, where all throughout high school, you know, being a five-star recruit, being the number one wide receiver recruit in the nation and Illinois and all that stuff and going down to the Big Bad SEC. He was the man. Who the man? He the man. Who the man? He the man. And then all of a sudden, you get lapped. You get lapped by some no-name jabroni from Detroit Lakes, Minnesota State. Mankato State. It'll always be Mankato State. As well as some fifth-round pick from Maryland. As well as Charles Johnson. As well as Cordarrelle. First round bust, as well as Jarius Wright. What is going on? And I think he fell behind the eight ball and he suffered. I mean, we saw that one catch for 15 yards as a rookie. It almost became the new 38-7, that whole thing. And then he put so much pressure on himself because he had that weight on his shoulders. It's like, I was the first round pick. I'm supposed to be a wide receiver one. I'm supposed to be the franchise changer. And you saw that it didn't work out. He crumbled. And even the last 2 years where he was basically force-fed and given the wide receiver three job in 2017, 2018, where he played around 40% of the snaps those seasons, he recorded 20 catches for 200 yards, zero touchdowns in 2017, and then 35 catches, 302 yards, and one touchdown, uno, in 2018. Cool. The Vikings declined his fifth-year option, and then in camp this year, in his fourth year as a lame duck, he was quickly lapped on the depth chart by Chad Beebe and Olabisi Johnson. So, again, that has to earth the ego a little bit. And then also, the final insult, Treadwell was cut at 53-man cuts after they couldn't trade him because no one wanted him. So, he tried out with the Bills and the Lions before eventually re-signing here with the Vikings week four. And here's where it comes into play, where major props to Treadwell for being mature enough and putting that ego aside enough to come back. Because a lot of players wouldn't have even given their original team a second thought. Because it's like, all right, screw you. I'm a first-round bust here. Whatever. I hate the fans. Fans can be brutal sometimes. It's whatever. But he knew that this was going to be his best spot for a chance for success in 2019 because he knew the system. He knows the locker room. Kirk Cousins and him also struck up a bit of a interesting rapport, especially on third down, especially in two-minute drill from 2018. So he had that going for him. And you know, he sucked it up, put his pride aside. I was like, all right, I'm assigned back here in Minnesota where I was a first-round pick, but I got cut. Now I'm on a league minimum deal. Whatever, I'm going to go out and play. And he's played well. And in the last two games with Thielen out, his snaps have increased. And he caught the 58-yard touchdown pass against Seattle that helped the Vikings get in the game late in the fourth quarter. And then also had two nice catches for 42 yards against Detroit. And I think him being cut and brought back is actually helping him because there is no pressure. There is no expectations. And he's just able to go out there and play. And you can tell, like, when he's out of his way, his own way mentally, he can ball. He does have skills. Also, he's another year removed from that horrific ankle injury, which can only help him even more. And so he's fine being the wide receiver for him, playing a little bit of special teams, mainly on kick return. So, again, major props to Quan for finding some new success in a new role. And, hell, at this point, the Vikings and Treadwell may even look to run it back next year. You know, bring him in on another minimal deal and see if he can rise up. It'll have him compete with Olabisi Johnson and Probably not Chad Beebe. but also like Dylan Mitchell year two and the whatever rookies they come in. But again, I got nothing but respect for Laquon Treadwell for coming back, like Buckner walking back into Shea and just doing the damn thing. Anyways, your thoughts, Laquon Treadwell, let us know in the comment section below. Also, subscribe Daily Vikings Takes. If you want to support the work, pull us on the Venmo. Plus, give us a follow on social media as well. But until next time, Skol, production value.